Hi, John.
Morning. Hair's matted. Material underneath is stained with blood. Obvious conclusion, some sort of head trauma. See, the presence of blood indicates coagulation hadn't taken place. She was dropped in hours after she was killed rather than days.
We need to find out when the site was completed, the exact date she was dumped.
Will it be a long job getting her out?
Well, we're going to take this one slowly.
Rush it and you could bugger up crucial forensics. Patrick and I will start trawling through the mispers.
Go!
Yeah, just coming. Trevor, sort out somebody to accompany the body.
Not me.
I've got a date tonight.
You're in the wrong job for that, kid.
Well, come on, let's toss for it. Heads.
The guys at the planning office say a community centre was built there in May 3 years ago.
Why were they building something new if the estate was always going to be pulled down?
Different departments. Left hand don't know what the right hand's doing.
Contractors?
Get back to me tomorrow.
Okay. Barry. Women possessing denim jackets missing before 2000.
That narrows it down a bit.
And lack of wisdom teeth infers this woman is likely to be less than 25 years old.
Do you get that? Less than 25. Her clothes look pretty youthful. Oh, and she's got a mole on her neck on the,
right.
The right-hand side.
Boys, mole, right-hand side of the neck. Thanks, Rosie.
Skull fragments embedded in the brain here. Number of indentations, diameter about 3 inches. Lump hammer, maybe? Quite some force was used. Positioning indicates your victim was attacked from behind. Given the number of indentations, this was a frenzied attack.
What about these? Defense wounds?
Unlikely. They're healed scars, quite fine, not too deep. Don't know. Craft knife? Carpet cutter, perhaps?
Hello.
Yeah. Gov?
Yep.
Rosie, line one.
Okay. Rosie.
A stitching scar on her left knee, possibly a sporting injury.
Okay.
Oh, and a historic puncture mark on the base of her spine.
It's tiny, but given its position, it could have come from a spinal tap.
Okay, thanks.
Surgery.
Any misper that's undergone hospital treatment?
Go.
Getting somewhere.
Yes, sir. This is looking very likely. It's 19-year-old Lucy Seabrook.
She could be our victim. She went missing, what, about 3 years ago?
Yeah, that's right.
Wasn't there a lot of publicity at the time?
Yeah, she was a leukemia sufferer as a child. Went into remission after treatment and was cured. She then turned her hand to fundraising as a thank you to the hospital. She raised $1 million over 8 years.
Her parents did that high-profile appeal.
Did the original inquiry look at family connections? Uncles, cousins?
Philip Seabrook's no family to speak of, brought up in care. Celia's family now live up north and visit yearly.
What about a boyfriend?
Parents didn't seem to think she had one. Same with the university friends. The original investigation failed to identify this man.
Maybe not, but I've got every faith in you people. Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
I've got a copy of the press appeal from when she went missing.
Great. Let's have a look at it.
And dark jeans. If you have any information, however small, please come forward.
I just want my baby back.
You got her now.
Poor woman.
Contractors have been in touch. Foundation was laid May 5th, 2000, morning after Lucy went missing.
They can be that precise?
Yeah, the concrete's brought in off-site.
Odontologist has been on. Lucy's dental records, they're a match.
Right. OK, Rosie, let's go and see the parents. Be with you in a minute, Anders. Mrs. Seabrook. No one knew what he saw in her. Turns out she had no gag reflex in her trick pelvis. Now, you two look like the gin and tonic types. Mrs. Seabrook?
Mm-hmm?
I'm DC Rosie McManus, and this is DI Vivian Friend.
Ah, you must be new. We know all the faces in CID.
We're from the murder investigation team.
Where did you find her?
I wonder if we could discuss this in private.
Well, she came back from college for the football, didn't she, Phil? Phil?
Yes.
She always used to go with her dad and the boys.
Should I take that?
A bit of a tradition, really. She stayed the night before for a battering. Bit of a catch-up.
What happened the night she disappeared?
That lot came back from the game, and I worked the bar so that Phil could have a few drinks with his mates. And she left about, I don't know, what was it, love, just after 10? Phil?
Yeah?
She said she had something on at the halls of residence.
About the pub. Was anybody acting suspiciously that night? You know, new faces, maybe?
Just the usual crowding.
So nothing of note that night?
No. How long are we going to be? Money at pub doesn't run by itself.
We bought this for Lucy. When she first went into hospital. She's only 4.
Acute lymphoblastic leukemia. Nothing much you don't know about ALL, is there, love?
No. She beat it, though. Oh. So strong and brave. An inspiration, you know.
Can we help?
I've got to go back to work. I can't look after the bar no more.
If you could wait downstairs, Mr...
Dean. Dean Guthrie. I'm a mate of Phil's.
They found Lucy.
I'm sorry, mate. Really, I'm...
When can I have her back? She's been on her own. She's been on her own too long.
As soon as the body's made available, then I'll...
Body? Body?
Oh, please, Phil.
Body?
Seabrook.
She said body!
Phil, stop it.
Shut up! You said body! Oh, that is my daughter! Her name is Lucy! Shut up! That is just a
Seabrook!
Get off me! Get off me! She's not her girl! And her name is Lucy!
Calm down,
shut up! Her name is Lucy and she's my little girl! Her name is Lucy. Miss Lucy.
Yeah.